fast to this declaration. That double will never fade our life in the name of Jesus. Let us be gearing up. The place of prayer is this one in verse 13. We have not been reading verse 13, but this is the place of prayer in verse 13. It says, when I have bent Judah for me, filled the bow with Ephraim, and raised up their sons, O Zion, against thy sons of Greece, and made thee as the sword of a mighty man. Verse 14 says, and the Lord shall be seen over them, and his arrow shall go forth as lightning, and the Lord God shall blow the trumpet, and shall go with wind of the south. So what the Lord is saying here in verse 13, yes, I will give you double. Yes, I will give you double. Yes, I will give you double. Yes, I will multiply you. What the word of God is saying in Zechariah, thank you for joining once more on Facebook. You know, he's saying that once what I will do to you is that I will give you double. And that double is this way. This is the double. What doubles will do in your life is like what will happen in verse 13. He said, "Hi God, I will bend Judah for me." That means God will use Judah as an instrument. I will bend Judah for my sake. I will bend Judah even when I've given her or Judah a double portion. I will use Judah for my sake. And in verse 13, Zechariah 9, verse 13, if you are just joining us, we have just read Zechariah 9, verse 12, which is our theme of this month, our month of double portion. But we don't want to like have double portion and just fold our hands. The Lord is saying in verse 13 that I will use you as an instrument, like the way I'm going to use Judah. He said, I will bend Judah, and he said to Ephraim that Ephraim will build, I will fill Ephraim in the bow. That means I will bend Judah like a bow. Have you seen a bow of arrow? Yes, the bow of arrow goes like this, and the arrow is placed on the bow for instrument. And you find that the Bible saying that bending will be like Judah, the arrow will be like Ephraim. And he said in verse, in continue, he said, I will raise up the sons of Zion. So that means the sons of Zion is still partakers of God's divine blessing. He said he will raise them. He will use them like a bow of arrow and shoot it against the adversary, against the opponent, against the thief, against the stealer of destiny, against the stealer of miracle, against, you know, discouragement of your life, against that sickness that is battling your health. He said, I will use you to be an instrument of destruction to every destroyer of your life. Hallelujah. That is why I tell you that indeed you are not a misplaced person in Christ Jesus. That's why I tell you tonight that our prayer tonight is not just an ordinary prayer. We are not just going to pray the way we normally pray. We are going to pray with a great understanding, with fervency, and say, Father, raise me as an instrument of destruction. That's what I'm going to say. I don't know whether you have prayed. David prayed this prayer one time in his word. He said, Father, use me to destroy all my enemies. He said, let my footstool, let my shadow become a destroyer, a destruction. Hallelujah. That is what we want to pray. I say, Father, this evening, use me as an instrument. Raise me as an instrument of destruction to every gainsayer or against my life. Every illness against my life. Every sickness against my life. Peradventure, you are sick. I don't know what COVID-19 has done to your body. But let me tell you, this is a time of prayer. And that is why we open up the forum for today. Normally, it is meant for the prayer, department, but today we open it up because the Lord's word has gone ahead that indeed there might be one or two people that needs this prayer in their life. Let me tell you, you can say, Father, raise me a prayer, raise me an instrument in my home to destroy every stealer of marriage, every stealer of relationship. Let me tell you, the devil is going round, not only before, even at this present time, even in this COVID-19, the devil is raising armies, is raising devices to make sure that relationship meets with destruction. Relationship between mother and son cannot flow again. Relationship between daughter and father, daughter and mother, does not exist again. Relationship between nations cannot hold again. Let me tell you, there are forces that the Lord wants us to in this time our feet against. And that is why I am coming your way tonight and say, Father, raise me an instrument. An instrument the way you said, oh God, you will raise Judah. The way you said you will raise Ephraim. The way you will raise Zion. Lord, raise me an instrument for destruction. Hallelujah. For destruction to, let me tell you, Jeremiah, the Bible say, Jeremiah, he said to Jeremiah, in Jeremiah, if you read Jeremiah, the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1 or so, he said, see, Jeremiah, I have appointed you, I have chosen you to bring down, to cut down, to uproot. And that is what God has is wanting us to do tonight. Every operation of the adversary, we are going to uproot them tonight in the name of Jesus. Every operation of the devil that has been going on during this COVID-19 or before COVID-19, we are going to destroy their holes and their grips in the name of Jesus. He said, behold, I have come that you might have life and have it in abundance. And he said to us, come upon me in the days of adversity, in the days of trouble. He said, hi, God. We answer you. I am not God. I am not God. I am not God. He said, hi, God, the God that living one, we answer you. So tonight, I want you to be on your feet wherever you are. I want you to charge up yourself wherever you are. Begin to, you know, if you have a rheumatism or leg pain, begin to encourage yourself. That might be a miracle coming to your way right now. Right now, right now. Begin to say, I am stronger. I can pray. You can begin to say, I can pray. Even though you are in the hospital bed, I know your hands can move. I know that your legs can move. Begin to say, I can pray. I'll pray to the Lord. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Begin to charge yourself right now. Begin to encourage yourself in the Lord and say, Father, tonight, as I cry unto you, Lord, every weakness in my body, let them vamoose, let them go, let them go, let them go, let them go, let them go. Every laziness in my body, let them go right now in the name of Jesus. Every tiredness in my bone, let them go in the name of Jesus. Every pain in my soul, let them go in the name of Jesus. Every sorrow in my body, let them go in the name of Jesus. Every emotion that have hindered me thus far, Lord, let them go in the name of, I can pray. I can declare, I can stand, I can declare, I can pray. Can you begin to declare it in the name of Jesus? Lord, we can pray. Lord, we can declare. Oh, Lord, we can pray. We can declare. We can say to mountains, and mountains will hear us tonight. We can say to barriers, and barriers, oh God, can hear us tonight. Lord, we can declare it. Lord, we can pray it. Lord, we can declare it. Lord, we can pray it. Lord, we can declare it. Lord, we can pray that in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we are going to pray tonight in chapter 10, Zechariah chapter 10, verse 1. The Bible says, ask ye of the Lord. Ask ye of the Lord. Reign the time of the latter rain. Ask ye of the Lord. Reign the time, and it says of the latter rain. That means the Bible is saying in chapter 10, Zechariah chapter 10, verse 1. He said you should ask the Lord that the Lord should rain the latter rain. I don't know what latter rain is in your mind. I don't know what is your latter rain. I don't know the expectation of latter rain. Peradventure you want this COVID-19 to end in a latter rain. I don't know what it is, but let me tell you, it is beyond COVID-19. It's beyond COVID, it's beyond the virus. I want you to have a mentality that indeed you will rejoice. No matter what a pandemic situation is, I will rejoice. I want my latter rain to bring blessing. Lord, this month of double portion, I want my latter rain to manifest breakthrough. I want my latter rain to manifest deliverance. I want my latter rain to manifest, Lord, a kingship. I want my latter rain to manifest, Lord, victory for me. Can you begin to pray it in the name of Jesus? Pray it in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, your word says I should ask you of my latter rain. This is my latter rain. Peradventure, you are there. You've been looking for the fruit of the womb. Thank you for joining us on Facebook. You are there. You've been looking for fruit of the womb. Let me tell you that indeed this is a time for you to say, Father, my latter rain shall end up with the cry of a baby in the name of Jesus. Peradventure, you've been in a relationship for years and it's not leading to marriage. You want to say, Father, Lord, my latter rain shall end in marriage in the name of Jesus. But eventually you have sons, you have children that are misbehaving. You can't understand that behavior. You want to say, Father, my latter rain upon my children shall end with victory, shall end with clear destiny, shall end with distinct destiny in the name of Jesus. Can you not begin to declare it? Begin to declare it in prayer. Begin to declare it in prayer. Begin to declare it in prayer. Declare it in prayer and say, Father, my latter rain, my latter rain, my latter rain, my latter rain shall end with victory. We end the victory. And you begin to see yourself and say, Father, I declare upon myself, I see my latter rain ending with victory, ending with victory, ending with success, ending with success, ending with victory in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be thou glorified. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Please, if you are on Zoom, I just received an alert now. They might cut the link off very soon. Please rejoin by clicking on the link that I've been giving to you. Praise the Lord. The Lord be control. The Lord be in control in the name of. The Bible says in Zechariah chapter 10, verse 1 that we have read, it says, you should ask ye of the Lord, rain the time of latter rain. So the Lord shall make bright clouds. It shall make bright clouds. You want to pray tonight and say, Father, every entrance to my bright cloud. Their bright cloud is not just, you just look at the sky and you see clear sky. That is not what the Bible, that's not what the scripture is saying. You know, bright clouds indicates that there is clarity. There is no obstruction. There is obvious. It is an obvious situation. There is no disruption in your blessing. There's no disruption in your double portion. There is no hindrances in your double portion. And how can you begin to demand this? How can you begin to ask this? As the Bible has said, is for you to begin to challenge a challenger and say, Father, you stiller of bright cloud. You stiller of bright cloud in my life. You stiller of bright cloud upon my home. You stiller of bright cloud upon my children. You stiller of bright cloud over my destiny. You stiller of bright cloud in my job. You stiller of bright cloud in my business. Lord, tonight I issue out ultimatum. Remove your hands. Remove your hands. Fade away. We pray, right away. You can even come and approach every stiller position itself against your life. You can indeed uproot their roots, uproot their oppression, call their oppression to be terminated in the name of Jesus. Can you begin to declare it? Begin to declare it. Stiller of bright cloud over my double portion. Lord, tonight, I silence the oppression. I silence the oppression. I thwart, oh God, the oppression. I put them in confusion. Lord, their mind shall not settle down. Lord, to put the enterprise into use in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Peradventure, you are the finance place member. I want you to pray, and you that is joining us, you are joining us because indeed the finest place people are praying. Hallelujah. So if you can join us and say, Father, in my church, among my brethren, the bright cloud is come. You want to declare it and say, the bright cloud is come. The Bible says that indeed, he said that, and the Lord shall make bright cloud. Bright cloud has no hindrance. Bright cloud has nothing to obscure it. And bright cloud brings a vivid clarity of things. So you want to pray tonight and say, Father, over my brethren, I declare bright cloud. I declare the divine bright cloud upon their career, upon their school, upon their businesses, upon their spiritual life. Bright cloud over their marriage. Bright cloud. When bright cloud is missing, marriage tends to be difficult. Marriage tends to be unresolved. Marriage relationships begin to knock head and scatter. You know, man and woman begin to not understand themselves again. These are people that have said, I love you. They've made vows upon vows at the altar. Yet, when no bright cloud is no more, when there is no bright cloud, their marriage begin to suffer. And you begin to wonder, where is that love that was once declared at the beginning of the relationship? So you want to pray, Father, over my members, over my church members, over my brothers and sisters, you that is the finest place, you want to say, oh, the finest place, over your marriage, over your relationship, the bright cloud of the Lord shall stand sure. The bright cloud of the Lord that brings strength shall stand sure. The bright cloud of the Lord that brings success shall stand sure in the name of Jesus. You want to pray over your home, you that is a married man or married woman, or you are a single parent, you have your child with you. You want to say, nothing shall separate me and my son. Nothing shall separate me and my daughter. Nothing shall separate me and my children. Lord, I pray the bright cloud of joy in this home shall not fade. The bright cloud of happiness will not fade in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. I tell you that indeed, we have only prayed a few prayers. And I tell you what, the devil and his cohort are already feeling heat. Hallelujah. They're already feeling. The Bible says, Before you pray, I have already heard you. Before you pray, I have already heard you. And that is what the Bible told Daniel. When Daniel started, he said, the first thing you pray, I have already answered you. I have already sent you answer. So tonight, I want also begin to celebrate and say, Father, thank you for making me an instrument of destruction. An instrument of destruction to the works of the devil, to the works of the enemy, to the works of the oppression. The Bible says, affliction shall not arise, shall not come back, shall not arise the second time. So the Lord is making you an instrument so that indeed you can be a source of joy to people. You can be a source of happiness to people. Tell the Lord, I say, Father, thank you for making me an instrument of destruction to the camps of the devil, to the camps of the wicked, to the stronghold of every evil life in the name of Jesus. Thank you for making me an instrument. Thank you, Father Lord, for making me an instrument. Thank the Lord for making you an instrument to the camp of the devil to bring their oppression down in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I want you also to thank the Lord, because indeed the Bible said that Daniel cried to the Lord and he continued praying. But there came a time when answer came to Daniel, and the Lord said to Daniel through his messengers that right from the day you started praying, I have already answered your prayer. I have already sent angels to favor you, to answer your prayer. I have already answered it. So tonight we are operating in faith and say, Father, thank you for answering the prayer. The prayer of the verse one of Zechariah 10 that we pray, he said that we should ask of the Lord of the latter rain. So you want to thank the Lord and say, Father, thank you for my latter rain. Thank you for my latter rain. I don't know what your latter rain is. Like as we have prayed, your latter rain can be, you know, a double portion in your marriage, a double portion in happiness, a double portion in the joy that fills your home, a double portion in among your children, a double portion of God's protection, a double portion of God's boldness in your ministry, in your ministerial work with God, a double portion of gladness, a double portion of success, divine success, financial success, you know, spiritual success, the double portion of God, it might become a latter rain in your life. Even at the end of this COVID-19, at the end of this virus, you want to say, Father, hey, my double portion will never fade. My double portion will be my latter rain for everlasting, for time to come. In that name, can you just thank the Lord for God answering that prayer? For God answering that prayer. For God answering that prayer. Thank the Lord for God answering that prayer. Thank the Lord for God answering that prayer. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. We want to thank God for God giving you a bright cloud. And that is the next prayer that we pray. We want to thank God, Father, thank you for the bright cloud of my life. Thank you because I am no more in confusion. I am no more in confusion. I know my destiny. I know my way. I know my direction. Lord, thank you for giving me the bright cloud in my home. Thank you for giving me the bright cloud in my family. Thank you for giving me the bright cloud in my ministry. Peradventure, you're an evangelist. You're a minister of God. You want to say, Father, thank you for giving me bright cloud in my ministry. Still I walk with you. Thank you for giving me bright cloud in my relationship with people in the name of Jesus. Peradventure, you're a worker, you are a staff of a company. Can you just say, Father, thank you for giving me a bright cloud in my daily walk, in the place you have placed me, at workplace, at my station, at workplace, at my occupation, at workplace. Thank you for giving me a brighter cloud in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be that glorified in Jesus' name. We are prayed. Amen. Congratulations. Can you just begin to wave a clap of offering? Just give the Lord a glory, praise. Give the Lord all adoration. Give the Lord all praise. Give the Lord all adoration. Wherever you are, on Zoom, on Facebook, on Twitter, can you just begin to give the Lord a wave of offering and say, Father, be that glorified. Be that glorified. Receive all that glory. 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 Receive all the glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be thou glorified, Lord. Be thou glorified, ancient of the days. Receive all the glory. Father, Lord, we thank you. Be thou glorified in the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Sorry, I'm just trying to look at the people that are still hanging on at one of our link that we sent. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. Be thou glorified. Thank you, Father, Lord, for today. Thank you for this evening. As many that have listened to the sound of our voice, as many that have joined us in the place of prayer, Lord, we pray that, Lord God, that destiny will never, Father, Lord, find a place of confusion. That destiny shall be with a brighter cloud that you will give. That destiny shall be met with latter rain that is everlasting. The latter rain that will last forever in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for that woman, for that man that is hearing the sound of our voice. Lord, we thank you, Father, Lord, for that boy, that girl that has tuned in this evening. Lord, we pray that indeed that confusion of your life will never take you to the place of no return. It will take you to the place of celebration of joy that the Lord God have blessed you, the Lord God have given you in the name of Jesus. That confusion in that are surrounding that you are right now, that indeed it shall bring forth the success of the Lord. It shall bring forth the victory of the Lord. The Lord shall use it to his own glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be thou glorified. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So I welcome you once more, and I believe that you will join us next time, next week, on Tuesday. I thank God that it will always be open for you on Facebook, and for Zoom people, the people that are on Zoom, it will always be open also. Let me tell you, the Lord is doing wonders, and I want you to be an instrument of praise. I want you to be an instrument that the Lord will use in this end time to destroy the works of darkness. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can we share the grace in fellowship? Remember, tomorrow is Bible study. You can join us on Zoom. If you need the link, I will send it through the Facebook page also, and you can join us on Zoom, and we will have the joy to study the Word of God together with the Pastor Walter Israel, to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Join us, and you will be happy that you did, because indeed it's a time for you to ask any question, ask that question that have been troubling your heart. Ask that question that maybe in your house fellowship, in your place of worship, they've not been able to, you know, give you a listening ear. I believe that tomorrow, if you can bring your question, the Lord God Almighty, the Holy Spirit will be ready to give you an answer in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. We give you all the praises as we end this gathering. Lord, we pray we are not ending our joy. We are not ending our happiness. Lord, we pray that as we go, Lord, our various dispatch place, Father, Lord, we pray that, Lord God, your joy that you have given unto us, that latter ray that you have already released upon our life, Lord, we never, Lord, suffer loss in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, for this boldness. Thank you, Lord, for this confidence. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. And the saints, we say, amen. Hallelujah. Can we share the grace in fellowship? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy will follow us all the days of our life, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Shalom. Peace be. May the Lord bless you and continue to give you strength to enjoy your double portion this month. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.